If you are a registered member of our website, you will be getting the periodic emails from us on different subjects, sometimes on the option strategy, sometimes on the trend analysis. So this weekly trend analysis, what we are doing, that normally we used to release on the every Friday post market hour, sometimes on the Saturday. And this is our website. You can go to the download link and you can download that particular report from this. And besides that, you'll be getting a follow-up email how it performed. So during that process of follow-up email also, I used to recommend specific option strategies to you. So last week's performance, most of you, if you have downloaded this particular report, you could have experienced. So this is the levels we have given. Nifty achieved fully. In fact, Nifty has opened up gap up. It has not provided the chance this week to enter as per this first cycle. So if you have the software, you could have entered in the second cycle. So Bank Nifty, very well, it has provided the chance to enter at 23,320 and achieved near to fourth target. So this is what you have achieved. Besides that, I used to give you different option strategies. And this week, and this option strategies, this is the 29th, I have emailed to all of you. If you are getting our emails, because this is a, means if the emails are landing in the spam box, just once you have to select and make it not a spam, so that it will land to your email box properly, to your inbox. So that day I have told you, Nifty and Bank Nifty Future achieved the 85th week's trend calculations perfectly. So this is the 85th week's calculation. It has achieved that, I have told you. And I have given you one good analysis also here. So that analysis I have told you, the 6th July expiry Bank Nifty options having the highest open interest in which strikes call and which strike put. So this call options having a highest open interest in this means it will find the resistance there. Put options having the open interest means it will find the supports there. So this is the meaning of that. 27th July expiry, where it is having the highest open interest, and put call ratio also I have given you. Though Bank Nifty put call ratio, if it is above 1.75 or 2, then only you can say it is in the uptrend. Again, I have told you the IV, this is very important. This analysis of IV you won't get in any of the option strategy books. So this is our own research. This is very, very important fact of the option strategy trader. I told you, when the call options having a more IV as compared to put, that signals the downtrend. When the put options having a higher IV as compared to the put, specifically 50% above the put, 50% above, that signals uptrend, means put options having a higher IV as compared to the call option. So this is a very concrete analysis. Why so? Why this put option having a higher IV signals a uptrend? That has a meaning, and you need to learn through our option strategy course to find out why it gives. If the put option having a higher IV, why it says that it is a uptrend? So that you can find it in our option strategy course. So I have told you this signals a uptrend. So based on that, I told you one net debit calendar spread to form in the 23,500 put, means you will be buying the 23,500 put option 27th July expiry. That time it was 392, and you need to sell a 23,500 put option of the 6th July expiry at 224. Maximum spread, the difference between this thing, I have recommended 155 to 165. This is what I have recommended. So yesterday was the 6th of July. So see what is the difference it has given. This is the data I have taken from NSE. The option you sold at 200 and on odd means the option which you have sold at 224 and expired at 30 rupees 80 paisa. Option you bought at 392, expired at 289. So the spread which is being initiated at 155 to 165, at one point of time it has gone to 135 and 130 also. So post my recommendations, it has ended with a spread of 260, so which made you to earn a profit of 4148 in a span of 8 days period, 8 calendar days period, with an investment of 50,000. So to initiate this particular strategy, you require some 50 to 55,000 rupees of margin. So the analysis is quite simple. You just have seen that open interest. You have just taken a put call ratio. You have just done a IV analysis, implied volatility analysis. This is the thing it is done. There is no other big technicality involved in that. So the thing is that if you seriously go through that 14 to 15 hours of literature given in that futures and option course, if you have seriously gone through the printed book which is of just 245 pages, and if you just spend 1 month time to master this subject, you can able to do this analysis. You don't require any person to analyze for you. So this is the performance in front of you. So similar way, many strategies I used to give. The very objective of strategy formation is the risk reward. So if you are losing, how much you will lose. If you are gaining, how much you will gain. I've just recommended 2000 to 3500. You have got more than that. 4100 has come. Similar way also, yesterday also I have given one more strategy to all of you. Yesterday also I have emailed one more strategy. This is, I have subjected it, Nifty is consolidating, how to take benefit of that. I have just told you to sell August month's 9700 call and 10,000 call and buy 9750 call option of July 2 lots. But much technicality of that I have not gone through. So profit and loss analysis I have given. Why I have recommended? Based on the same open interest, same put call ratio analysis. So if you just little concentrate on those two facts, you'll see that yes, this strategy, and you can experience this strategy. I have given a maximum 10 days of holding period, and it is some 80 to 85,000 of margin it blocks. So 10 days maximum I have given, level where it will give you the profit, level where it will give you the losses, that also I have mentioned, so that you can experience through that. So the very point is, you can make money in the market. However, you must have that openness to learn. You must have that interest to learn and master certain techniques. And you must control your greed. Greed in the sense, if you are expecting every month some 60%, 70% return to come, just like that, without having any work done, without learning anything about the market, then you are in a wrong place. You'll never earn from the market. So we'll be starting today's session around 9:15 once the market opens. We'll give some pull-off period, then we'll start. Today's subject of discussion will be on intraday trade, on option arbitrage trade. These two things I'll be focusing today. Before that, spend a couple of minutes to understand Smart Finance's products, its activities.
Good morning, friends. I am Dr. Meeta here. If you have any product-related query, please put in the chat box. Quickly, we will attend those things. Coming to our product list, we have total 12 varieties of products, as you can see in our website. So people ask, what is the unique feature in these products? In all our products, there is one common thing what you will be finding. That is the thing, every concept is backed with a strong analysis, as you are experiencing today in Mr. Ranjan's lecture, where the option strategy, whatever he recommends, he has a strong concrete analysis behind that. He never simply says that you buy this or you sell this, this is the loss, this is the profit, etc. Why he says to buy such an option, why he says to sell such an option, why the strategy he forms, he always, always validates. This is true with all our products, not only option strategy. GAN, volatility, technical analysis, Elliott Wave, any course you think of, every course we have designed in that way only. We have validated with concrete analysis. Coming to our two of the products which you will be dealing with today. Number one is the standard deviation, first standard deviation product. Number two is the option strategy product. Standard deviation is our latest product, huge and huge success. Feedback is extremely good about this. This is available at the cost of 5,000 rupees, which gives two versions of the software. That is for laptop or desktop one, and other is for the Android. At the cost of 5,000 rupees per annum, you can avail this. For intraday and positional, both kinds of trades, you can use it. And there is a strong past performance report, which is very much challenging and quite impressive if you compare with the other products of anywhere else. We have a strong back report of its success consecutively 79 weeks. 79 weeks out of 87 weeks it has given success. And this success, we are saying, it is in the public platform we have been demonstrating since last 87 weeks. How is that? We have been giving Nifty Bank Nifty next week trends using standard deviation concept in our all public platforms, like in our website, like in our YouTube, Facebook, Twitter, in all places we have been demonstrating giving this. And out of those 87 weeks forecast, it has achieved success in 79 weeks. Such a strong record of success it is having. So how recently, on the demand of the buyers, we have added very interesting features into it. That is the scanner, stock scanner, option scanner. How it works and how far it is successful, that Mr. Ranjan will demonstrate you. In the live market, we are going to show it. So it is very important to the session to see in live market how the stock scanner of 1SD software works. Coming to the second product, we have option strategy builder software available that costs you 10,500 rupees. Recently, we experienced one strategy explanation by Mr. Ranjan. So that tool, if you wish to purchase, that comes at the cost of 10,500 rupees for the first 1 year. Next year onwards, it will be 3,500 rupees. That is the annual maintenance cost for all our tools. This is the same cost only. Now, after you purchase the tool, what about the support, post-sale support, how we provide that? I am glad to inform you, we are starting a new support system in addition to the existing ones. Existing ones is that after the buyer makes purchase, we give supporting mail ID where you can put your queries, and we have technical staffs available to attend your queries through email. And second support we have been giving is we have a technical staff team available here for the tools related query, that is the back office people. So between 10 and 6, always they are available over telephone. You can ask them if your tool is giving you any problem, software related problem. For concept related queries through email, we have been giving you the support. Now the new support system what we are launching now is from this month of July. This month of July, monthly once we will have the buyers meet. Monthly once we will have the buyers meet, where the buyers will directly meet Mr. Ranjan online. Mr. Ranjan's session will be there. In the buyers meet, where he will teach you certain new things, certain option strategies, certain trend analysis, certain his experiments. In addition to that, you can put your grievances if you have anything, or if you have any doubt, you can directly ask him. This support is absolutely free of cost for all our buyers. So that is the buyers meet. So further, if you want to know about our any other products, feel free to call in our given numbers. 98403-48971.
Whether one standard deviation principle works in the commodity market. Definitely it will work. The reason is, whenever you ask that question, does the commodity having a different technical studies as compared to the stock, equity and future? Does a new formula is there for the commodity for 10 days moving average, 15 days moving average? Does the commodity uses a different Fibonacci ratio as compared to the equity and future? Then it is using the same method. It is just software doesn't understand whether it is a commodity or whatever may be. These names is nothing for the software. This prices is just a number for the software. So prices based on the number only it analyzes. It calculates the volatility from the price points, which is also a number. So hence it very well works in the commodity also. Period of 10 to 15 minutes, I always say. The reason behind it is this system works on a real-time volatility estimate. So if you just give very less time, only 5 minutes, 3 minutes, so it has lesser data available. So it won't give you a correct predictions. So if you just give little more flexibility, some 5 to 7 minute time, you'll definitely get a chance to trade. Same time, the calculations will be very strong. So for that reason, only 5 to 7 minute time is required. You may not get the chances to trade in all stocks. However, you will get the chances to trade in the stocks. We are doing for the Nifty future. So I'm just going for opening one Excel sheet. Time will be there. Do not worry about that. And do it properly. So analysis part is very, very important. So this is the put side. We are going to take the put side. So this is the put side and this is the call side. This is the number of calls and puts available. So this is the calls. So now let me have a put call ratio analysis. It's divided by this. So 1.30. So this says that we are in uptrend. Then going to the specific strikes open interest, we are having the 600, 700, 800. These are the three strikes having the equally higher open interest in calls. And we are having 600, 500 and 400 having the higher open interest in the put side. And 9,500 is having the highest open interest. So I can say that 9,500 may act as a great support, and 9,600 also is a great support. Now going to the IV. So pretty interesting picture here. So IV of the call options are only 5 to 6% average, or I can say 6 to 6.5. However, IV of put options are 12. So much higher. So this also signals a uptrend. So these are the things is giving me an indication that it is in uptrend. Trend has not changed with this particular correction. So let me move to the part of the, let me move to that now. 9643 will be your stop loss. Take a note of this, and you must hedge it with 9650 put option or 9600 also, but better hedge it with the 9650 put option. So 9650 put option, you try to hedge it. So 9650 put option, you can try to hedge it. 9650 put option is quoting at 82. So this trade will be 982 rupees. The 9650 put option you should buy, and buy a future at 9662 level. So just 1 or 2 point difference, do not worry. Think of why. 42, if the stop loss of 42 triggers, here 43 triggers, better just little wait till 36, 9636 level. If it is falling below, 1 or 2 minutes time you give, just it is touching, do not come out. 1 or 2 minute time you give, then you can come out. Bank Nifty. So this is the calculation. 23,506 above uptrend, 23,440 below the downtrend. What is the current price? 480. Please wait. Let it give a breakout. Let it give a breakout. Then you can initiate the trade. So you are using this particular put for your hedging. So there is no stop loss for this particular put. If the future hits the stop loss of 23 points, stop loss what is there? Out of that 23 points, 13, 14 or 15 points of prop means you can recover from this put option. That's why you are buying. So if you are buying the Bank Nifty here at 23,505, 23,505, try to hedge it with the 23,500 put weekly options. That is 13th of July options. Try to hedge it. Try to hedge it. So try to hedge it with that particular thing. Now moving to the next. So I'll be moving to the stock future. And here I have taken Tata Steel. All these things also recorded. So here Tata Steel, I'll be calculating. So this is the level you got, 545 above uptrend, 542 below downtrend, 545 above it is there now. So if you are buying this particular future, 547.75. So nothing wrong, you can buy very well. It is here only in this particular zone. So if you are buying the Tata Steel here, 545.75, you must hedge. With which strike you should hedge? So nearest strike option stock, I'll go for Tata Steel, and Bank Nifty has not given us the breakout. 540 is the nearest. 540 I am buying, must have a put option. So 540 is at 11 rupees. 540 put option at 11. At 11. All these options we are buying only to hedge the future. Our intraday objective, once it is achieved, first or second target or third target, we will just trail the stop loss and use it. This is for Tata Steel. HDFC Bank, I am taking. This is the load data I have done. I have loaded the data. Now calculate 1658, 1655 and currently at 1663. So here is one little problem. Is there 63 it has come. So it has come to this particular level. Crossed the second target as per my estimation for the first cycle. So what I should do? Last session also I have told you. Anyone has remembered that? Currently 1663 above, what I should do? Last session, most of them are saying that we must wait for the second cycle. First cycle we have penetrated. So penetrated, achieved couple of targets. We must wait to buy above this 66. If it is coming, we should buy. And nearest option we should hedge. Suppose after touching this 1661, 63, it is coming to 1658. Shall I buy? After touching this level, I'm currently experiencing 63. So it has not gone up further. It has just fallen down and come down to 58. Shall I buy it? No. No, you must not buy this. Only second cycle you are allowed to buy as per the swing trading principle. It is not my principle. As per the swing trading principle, once one trend matures, next cycle you should buy. Or you can sell at 1655. If it is surrendering and coming back to 1655, you can sell. These two things is only allowed for you. First cycle penetrated, nothing to do. Second cycle point you have to wait, and your growth cluster will be the stop loss for the second cycle entry. And if it is surrendering gains and coming to the sell entry level, you can sell. So this is the things for HDFC Bank you can do. Now moving into the factor of our option arbitrage. What is that? How much arbitrage values are there we have to? So here I am just loading Nifty. I am going for option arbitrage. It is a tool available in the Smart IT tool. So here it is saying that call options less 14 rupees having a lesser, here 8 rupees having lesser, here 2 rupees, here some excessness is there, 9800 call. So this is the arbitrage, means it should be the trading at 140, it is trading at 126. It should be trading at 103, it is trading at 94. It should be trading at 71, it is trading at 68. Uptrend breakout is being given, 9662, 9662 uptrend given. Just now we have seen. So if I want to enter the arbitrage trade, I can think of this one. I can buy this one, which is having 8 rupees lesser value. I can think of 750, which is having 89 paisa excess value. I can sell this in the uptrend. Once it is going on achieving the higher and higher targets in the uptrend, what will be the maximum arbitrage gain I can get in a day? 8 rupees 56 paisa plus this 1 rupee. So 9 rupees comes to 9 into 75. This is the maximum I can get. When I should book the loss and come out? When the Nifty fall down to 9636 level, which is my downtrend. So if it is going to higher and higher targets, one or two levels of target or three level of target, maximum this is the arbitrage gain it can give me. 10 rupees means around 750 for lot of trade I am having. So I can book the losses at 960, few hundreds will come, maybe 100 or 50 losses that time you can get. So this is how you should do an arbitrage trade. This kind of combination, if it fits, it, you can take it and it should beat your brokerage and other expenses that I am not considering. You need to look into if I am getting 750, whether I will be in profitable condition. Brokerage, taxes, everything is there. Option arbitrage for the Bank Nifty, great levels are there. See the great prices is there. It is monthly options. 36 rupees, 33 rupees, 24, 14. So these are the amount of money it is there in that. So you can form the combination which is best suitable for your profit and loss and you take this. Arbitrage trade is the most safest trade for a trader. So this is what you have got it. Now let us move to the new feature what we have brought. So for that I need to connect to the TeamViewer. So Aurobindo Pharma we have not seen. So one pharmaceutical company also, let us see. So 86, 89 level it has come, 88. So better wait for the second cycle or let it come to the downtrend level. You can take a call on that. So Aurobindo Pharma also we have analyzed. You can see that also. So added. So this is the new features we have added. Option scanner, stock scanner. So first let me move to the stock scanner. So stock scanner is very, so here it is only available for the futures, not for equities. I have selected intraday, low data. This simplifies your job to a great extent. So here stocks in uptrend as per the one standard deviation. So 9 stocks are in the uptrend today. So this is the 9 stocks which has given the uptrend. So any stock you choose, you can choose any stock of your choice and see its trend levels. Same way, go to reanalyze, go for the downtrend. How many stocks in the downtrend? 19 stocks in the downtrend. So you can go with any of this stock and view its targets. Same way, go to the reanalyze, see the stocks which has given a gap up. What is the gap up? So here the group is the stocks given a gap up. Stocks in the uptrend, these two are the stocks which you can buy. Stocks in the downtrend and stocks in the gap down are the group of the stocks which you can sell. And this is the group of the stocks which is between the buy and sell. They have not given any trend breakout. They will be giving this trend breakout in future. So this is also very great list, you can get it here. So this, you can say, this list will give you the clear cut information that which are the, see, Bank Nifty also coming here. It has not given any trend breakout. We have just now seen in that desktop edition. So once it gives the trend breakout, you can take a call on that. So this is what, this is how it scrutinizes the stocks and it scrutinizes the stock, and based on that, it simplifies your job that which group of stocks I should buy for the day, which stock group of stocks I should sell for the day, which group the stocks is appropriate for the future trend breakout. So this is the things you can do. Now moving to this particular other feature, option scanner. This is also a great tool. So you will be always thinking that, okay, you have told me Nifty has given this uptrend breakout. Which strike option I should buy? Which strike option I should sell? Which kind of option, which strikes will be beneficial for me for the day? These are the questions will be always making you confused. So we just made a great thing here. So I'm just selecting Nifty and I'm selecting this 27th July. I'm just loading the data. So here once I will be selecting the call options, I mean uptrend. So call options, this is little complex. So call options greater than equal to last traded price. So all options which is above the last traded price in an uptrend can give me a chance to get profit. So this is what I can do it. So I have just is in the uptrend. So I can think of buying. So now think that let me little bit more scrutinize it. So calls which is greater than equal to the last traded price, but I just want the strikes which I can buy in the uptrend. Means with the strikes which is falling between the uptrend breakout to, so the strikes which is falling between this 9672 to the target 9715, between these targets. So these are the, again I have, these are the strikes if you can buy, it will be beneficial for intraday. So this is a scanner, it is beginning. And it has what is the IV, where you should buy, currently it is 67, here you should buy, what will be your first target, what will be your stop loss. If you are buying at 71.78 or 72, your stop loss will be 63.58. So likewise, you can do lot of filterings in this, calls to sell in the downtrend. Same way you can go for the put. So puts to buy in the uptrend, puts to sell in the uptrend, puts to buy in the downtrend. So this also you can get it. You can also get it. I do not want to put any greater than, less than, all these conditions. I want the best. So here, strikes between the buy entry and targets, strikes between the sell entry and targets, best weekly put options to sell in uptrend, best weekly put options to buy in downtrend. So this kind of filtrations also there. Same way if you select the call, this also will give you strikes between buy entry and targets, strikes between the sell entry and targets, best weekly call options to buy, best weekly call options to sell. So this filtration just give you one or two strikes. Just based on that you enter. So though 1SD works, but if it is little bit of filtering it does, then it will be pretty good. So this facilities you can get in this particular software. So this is what the new features added in that. You have seen that how we can do the analysis. Bank Nifty has given an uptrend, has not achieved any target. Bank Nifty, we are waiting to get something, and Tata Steel, though we enter, it is entered to the downtrend level. Aurobindo Pharma has given a second cycle breakout, 95 level also in between it has come, 93 level we have expected, 88 level we have taken. So 95 level, 96 level, it is there now. So we can, Tata Steel still is in the loss. Stahl is in the still in the loss. And some amount we are recovering from this particular put option. So this is what we got in that. So stop loss ka definition ye hota hai, jahan pe trend badlega usi ko stop loss bolte hain. Stop loss ye nahi hota hai ki mere man ko bhaya, main do rupya niche laga diya and wo trigger bhi ho gaya, to main to khush, 2 rupya mere ko laga. बट 2 रुपया लगने के बाद में और 3 रुपया नीचे गया, उसके बाद में 20 रुपया ऊपर चला गया, तो ये स्टॉप लॉस का डेफिनेशन के साथ में मैच नहीं करता है. जब भी आप ट्रेड करेंगे उसका सही मीनिंग समझिए. जो स्टॉप लॉस होता है उसको बोलते हैं जहां पे ट्रेंड बदलेगा. रेजिस्टेंस क्या होता है? जहां पे प्राइस जिसके ऊपर आएगा नहीं, क्यों नहीं जाएगा, उसका भी एक एनालिसिस होना चाहिए. तो सभी चीज का एक स्टडी है एंड वो स्टडी हमको जानना जरूरी है. सो अरविंद फार्मा व्हिच हैज गिवन यू द अपट्रेंड ब्रेकआउट जस्ट नाउ, इट इज गिविंग यू 699 लेवल, इट इज कमिंग टू योर थर्ड साइकिल. इन फ्रंट ऑफ यू इट हैज हैपेंड. यू कैन हेज इट, यू कैन टेक अ बेनिफिट. इन फ्रंट ऑफ यू इट हैज हैपेंड. टेक अ नोट ऑफ दिस प्राइसेस. And if you go for the web view, so I'm just going for the web view, somewhat more clarity on Aurobindo Pharma's target you will get. First cycle, second cycle, third cycle. Third cycle ka 706, 706 is the third cycle. Last point it is coming. Think what is happening during the day. If it is going maximum 706, I am expecting maximum that one. So this is the web view. You can see this targets maximum. So this is for the Aurobindo Pharma, only one counter we got the breakouts and achieved the specific. Out of these 5 counters, HDFC we are still waiting for second cycle. Bank Nifty we are waiting. It has not given a trend breakout. Nifty we have entered into, not into the profit, neither into the loss. Aurobindo Pharma we have entered into, got a success. Tata Steel we have entered into, couple of points losses are there. So couple of points losses are there. Outcome of our analysis till 950, this is the outcome of our analysis till 950, which we have started from 9 o'clock or 950, or 920 we have started the analysis. Interest to learn, if you just take up this course and just spend 1 month time, 2 to 3 times you just go through that lectures, I am pretty sure you'll definitely get that success. You must have an intent to learn. You must have the interest to learn, and just little bit of practice you should do with the paper trades and all. That's all. That is not a great thing. So, and that is what is required. That is what is required. निफ्टी का एनालिसिस मॉर्निंग में किए, ये बताया खरीदने के लिए 65 का पॉप, ये उसका टारगेट्स होता है. फर्स्ट टारगेट 78 में, सेकंड 683 में, थर्ड 91 में, 9691. स्टॉप लॉस 42 में आपको बताया, जो आप खरीदे हैं हेजिंग के साथ में, 9650 का पुट ऑप्शन 82 के साथ में फ्यूचर को खरीदे हैं, 36 स्टॉप लॉस लगाइए. तो देखते हैं इसका क्या रिजल्ट होता है. बैंक निफ्टी का ये कैलकुलेशन निकला 23,506 के ऊपर में अप ट्रेंड, 23,440 के नीचे में डाउन ट्रेंड. तो इसका कोई ट्रेंड ब्रेकआउट अभी तक नहीं दिया है, देखते हैं उसका क्या आता है. टाटा स्टील का ब्रेकआउट दिया 4575 में, इसको 9,540 का पुट ऑप्शन 11 रुपया के साथ में लिए हैं, इसका आउटकम भी देखेंगे. एंड एचडीएफसी बैंक का फर्स्ट साइकिल ऑलरेडी पेनिट्रेशन में है, अगर वो 1665 के 66 के ऊपर में जाता है तो खरीदेंगे, नहीं तो 1658 के नीचे आता है तो बेचेंगे. तो यही मैं बताया आपको, सॉरी 1655 के नीचे में आता है तो बेचेंगे, 1666 के ऊपर में जाता है तो खरीदेंगे। ये भी हम देखेंगे इवनिंग तक क्या होता है। अरबिंदो फार्मा का जो एनालिसिस हम किए उसमें फर्स्ट साइकिल पेनिट्रेट हो गया था 693 में हमारा टारगेट बन रहा था, इसमें से ऑलरेडी अभी 697 एंड 99 तक आ गया है, 699 यहां तक आया है, 70 पैसा इसमें से लैकिंग हुआ है, तो सेकेंड साइकिल का फाइनल टारगेट तक आ गया है। ये एक ट्रेड फायदा में है, बाकी का निफ्टी में होल्डिंग में है एंड बाकी तीनों काउंटर में टाटा स्टील में थोड़ा सा लॉसेस है, बाकी तीनों में ब्रेकआउट नहीं किया है। 330 तक इसको फॉलो कीजिए, देखिए ये वीडियो भी मैं अपलोड करूंगा, देखिए अगर आप देखते हैं हाँ ये काम करता है उसके बाद में आप डिसाइड कीजिए कि ये सॉफ्टवेयर को मैं लेके अपने काम में लगाऊं या नहीं। अगर काम नहीं करेगा तो उसका कोई फायदा नहीं है, अगर काम करता है इसका लेवल्स जो निकला वो सही में काम करता है तब जाके आप डिसाइड कीजिए हाँ ये एक टूल है मैं लेके लगा सकता हूं अपने काम। इफ दिस वीडियो आई हैव टेकन एंड आई विल पुट इट इन आवर यूट्यूब चैनल, सो हियर इन आवर वेबसाइट यू जस्ट गो टू द यूट्यूब हियर, क्लिक हियर यू विल लैंड इन आवर यूट्यूब चैनल, सो हियर द वीडियो विल अपीयर। वंस दिस वीडियो यू आर गेटिंग, व्यू दिस वीडियो, share this video with your friends and give a like in this video if you like this video is good, so that others also will be encouraged to see that video. Give a like, forward it to your friends so that let them at least learn something.